for the first time, you reach for that door and you realize you ain't got nowhere to go. And so you got your little green plastic bag with all your clothes in it. On the side of the house, this abandoned house, and there's no electricity in the house. So you grab your little green bag and you sit on the floor by the wall. And then all of a sudden you hear something in the next room. You're only 14. You hear something in the next room. It's another abandoned man in the other room. You get your stuff and you start running. You think he gonna get you? Because you're 14 and you're homeless. And you go to your friend's house who lives in an apartment building and you sit on the stairs. And it's warm in the building. And every time somebody come out that door, you get up. He was just getting ready to leave. Because you're 14 and you're homeless. And then you learn the streets, and you learn how to shoot dice real good. Huh, 6 and 9, 10 and 4, Nina, give my money. You learn how to shoot pool real good, low left, low right, back up, give my money. You learn what it feels like to talk to Mr. Speaker. You learn how it is. You learn what it feels like to get shot. You learn what it feels like to get stabbed. You learn all the ways of the streets. But then some teacher, you all of a sudden run about an adult, and that adult looks at you and says something that nobody said to you before. That adult looks you in your eye and says, if I had a son, he would be like you. Like whatever. Even people who try to talk nice to you, you can't even hear them. Because you're so full of rage, you're so angry, because of everything you've been through all your life. And even the people who try to put you up on real game, she said to me, you're going to be something when you grow up. I said, whatever. You don't know me. Why are you talking to me? You don't know me. Why are you talking to me? Because I was full of rage and anger, and I couldn't see the future. But every time she saw me, she said, something special about you. And then one day I got it. I got this thing. And she told me to read this book. And I kept avoiding her because I didn't like to read. And then one day I knew I was going to see her. And she kept treating me so nice that I sat down and I read the book. It was just one little chapter she told me to read. And the book started out and said, my son. And a light went on in my mind. And I began to start to see that not only could I read, but I could unravel complex theories and complex equations. I began to recognize that my mind was so powerful that I could discombobulate the average individuals, utilize the terminologies and phraseologies, conducive to their purpose effectively. I found out I was a cold man. Ladies and gentlemen, I submit to you this. To that two people that I'm talking to in the room, I submit to you this. That every super achiever has the ability to outfocus you. Tiger Woods cannot hit the ball farther than everybody. The Kobe Bryant can't not necessarily just outjump everybody, but what they can do is this. That every super achiever has the ability to outfocus you. I have the ability to outfocus my peers. I can read for hours upon hours upon hours and digest complex information greater than most human beings on the planet. I have the ability to outfocus you. When you find people who don't succeed, the one thing, the reason why they cannot is because they cannot
focus.
Focus. You are at an age right now, ladies and gentlemen, that you'll be able to see your peers today. When you walk up and down these halls, you'll be able to see the winners. The winners think different. We walk different. We challenge ourselves different. We focus different while everybody else is playing around. Because they don't realize while they're playing today that the future is worth out of the moment. What you do now is what happens tomorrow. If you never want to see your future, ask yourself a question at the end of each day. What did I do today to make my dream of tomorrow come true? If the answer to that question is nothing, What do you think you'll have?
Nothing.
Watch this. If you ever want to know how much money you have in your pocket, all you have to do is ask yourself, who are my three closest friends? If your three closest friends are broke, you're broke too.
That's crazy.
Let me end my presentation by saying this. Here's what I learned about this stuff. You see this right here? I learned a secret about this stuff. I learned a secret. You proved my point. You proved my point without even realizing it. If you took this money and put it on a steel pole and attached it to a horse's head, how long would it take before the horse could get it? Wait, who said what? I'm going to say it again because somebody got it quick. If you take a steel pole and attach it to a horse's head and put this money at the end of it, how long would it take before he could get it? Why? Watch this. The secret I found out about this is the same secret I found out about. Let me take this book right here. On this page is. It's my book, I wrote it. What is on this piece of paper?
Words.
What is on this piece of paper?
Words.
Watch this. Because this information no one told you before, that's why you're trying to get it the way you are. No one ever told you this before. No one ever told me this before. But I guarantee you this. The person with the most of this will attract the most of this. The person with the least amount of this will chase this for the rest of your life. Ready again?
Show me their hope, and I'll show you their possibilities.